Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, we'll be taking addition and subtraction of directed numbers. This particular topic has some rules, basic rules. We need to follow them strictly for us to get our answer right. Else, our answer will be wrong. So, let's go through the rules guiding this topic before we forge ahead. Rule number one, when you have the same sign, all you need to do is to add and take the sign. Since you're having the same sign, just add and take the sign. For example, we have minus 3 plus minus 4. Minus 3 plus minus 4. Look at this. They're having the same sign. Minus, minus. So what you just need to do, if you are to follow the rule, because they're having the same sign, just add 3 plus 4 to give us 7. Then we just take the sign. Two of them are having the same sign, minus. That is what the rule says. Even when they're having the same sign, just add the number and just take the sign. Let's take another example. 3 plus 7. You know, naturally, when you write a number, there is an invisible sign there, which is plus. So, any number you put down, there is a sign there. The natural sign that is there is plus. So, we have 3 plus 7. Just add this number, 3 plus 7 will give you 10. The natural sign that is there is plus, is there already. So, when you have the same sign, just add the number and take the sign. We add 3 and 7, which is 10, and take the sign. We add 3 and 4, which is 7, just take the sign, minus 7. That's for rule number 1. Rule number 2. When you have different signs, subtract and take the sign of the largest absolute value. When you have different signs, just subtract them and take the sign of the largest value. Now, look at this example. We have minus 5 plus 9. The sign here is minus, the sign here is plus. So, you have different signs this time around. All you just need to do is to minus them. 9 minus 5 will give you what? 4. Now, you take the sign of the largest value. The sign of the largest value here is plus. So, you leave here as plus. Let's take another example. Minus 13 plus 8. Now, they're having different signs. This one is having minus, this one is having plus. All you need to do first is to, since they're having different signs, you have to go by the rule. We minus them first. 13 minus 8, you give us what? 5. Then you take the sign of the largest value. The largest value here is 13. You just take the sign and put it here. Let's take the third rule. When you are multiplying the same sign, the result will be positive. If you are multiplying the same sign, the result will be what? Positive. For example, you have minus here, the same sign, minus here. Okay, let's say this one is minus 1. Minus 1 times minus 8. You are having the same sign, the result will be positive. The result will be plus, the same sign, minus 1, minus, just times it. 1 times 8 will give you 8. Just take the, because they're having the same sign, minus, minus, the answer will be plus. Let's take another example. We have plus here. You can also put 1 here as well. If you are multiplying the same sign, this one is plus, plus, the same sign. 1 times 5 will give you 5. The sign here is what? Plus, just. So once you are multiplying and they have the same sign, look at this one, minus, minus, your result will be plus, 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 your result will be plus. And the last rule, when you are multiplying different signs, the result will be minus. Okay, look at this, we have minus here, we have plus here. Just say 2 times 8 will give you 16. Because they are different signs, the answer will be minus. Look at this one, we have plus 3 here, we have minus 5 here. The sign are different. We have plus here, we have minus here. So 3 times 5 is 15. The result will be minus. So once you are multiplying different signs, the answer will be minus. Once you are multiplying the same sign, the answer will be plus. So we have some questions here. With this our rule, let's apply our rule and solve the questions we have here. Look at this. 8 plus minus 1. Now look at this 8. It's having what? A plus sign. You know, you see when we're having a number, we have an invisible plus there. Now, what does the rule say? The rule says if you are adding two numbers, this is you are adding, and they have different signs, just do what? Let's check again. You may not be coming back for some other ones, but so we can apply the rule. When you have different signs, subtract and take the sign of the largest number. When you have different signs, like what we have here now. This one is plus, this one is minus. Just subtract and take the sign of the largest number. So we say 8 minus 1 give us what? 7. Just take the sign of the largest one, which is plus. Just leave it here, plus. So we may not be going back to those rules again. You can always pause and rewind to check those rules yourself. So let's forge ahead. If you are adding numbers of the same sign, look at this, minus 4 plus minus 8. Just add them and take the sign. Just add them. So 4 plus 8 will give you a 12, right? And just take the sign. That's what the rule says. Just add them. If you're adding numbers of the same sign, just add them and take the sign. Okay, if you are adding numbers of different sign like we have here, you minus them and take the sign of the largest number. You minus them and take the sign of the largest number. So let's just minus this. 8 minus 7 will give us what? 1. Okay, you take the sign of the what? Of the largest number. The largest number here is 8. You just take the sign. The largest number. Let's move to the next one. If you're adding numbers of the same sign, just add them and take the sign because they're having the same sign, right? So 5 plus 2 will give you what? 7. They're having the same sign. Just take their sign, which is minus. Awesome. The next one, if you are adding numbers of different sign, this one is plus, this one is minus, just minus them and take the sign of what? The largest number. So 3 minus 2 will give you 1. The sign of the largest number here is plus. Just leave it here as plus. Let's move to the next one, question number 6. Look at this one. They are in 3 places. We just apply the same rule. Fortunately for us, they are all having the same sign, minus, minus, minus. If you can check the rule, you can rewind to check the rule. If you are having the same sign, all you just need to do is to add them and take the sign. All you just need to do is to add them and take the sign. It is as easy as that. So with this, say 19 plus 8, that will give you what? 27. 27 plus 15 will give you what? 42. Let's put your 42 down here. Because they are all having the same sign, let's take the sign. Awesome. That is what the rule says. You are adding numbers that have the same sign. Just add all of them and take the sign that is there because they're having the same sign. The next one, if you are adding numbers with different signs, just subtract them and take the sign of the largest value. That's what you are asked to do. In this case, now look at this. You are having this one to be what? Minus, this one to be plus, this one to be plus. So what are you going to do? Just say this one, 4 plus 15 will give you what? 19. Okay, now I have minus here, minus 9 plus 19. Remember the rule says, if you're having numbers of different sign, just minus them and take the sign of the largest value. So you have 19 here, you have 9 here. Just minus them, 19 minus 9 give you what? 10. So 19 is having, 19 is the largest value, so you take the sign which is plus. So you just leave the plus here, because plus is always invisible. Go to the next question. Look at this. You are subtracting this time around. You have the same sign now, the same sign, minus 8 and minus 4. What does the rule say? If you're having the same sign, just add the number and take the sign. 8 plus 4 will give you what? 12. Just add the number and take the sign. They are both having the same sign. Just put it minus. The next one that we're having here, we are subtracting this one this time around. We have a rule here. I need to refer us back to this rule. Look here. We have minus 1 times minus 8 here. All we just need to do is to multiply the number. The sign will be plus, because the rule says when you are multiplying the same sign, the result will be plus. When you are multiplying the same sign, the result will be plus. So now you are multiplying the same sign, this minus and this minus, the result will be what? Plus. That means we now have minus 8 here plus 12. And another rule says if you are adding different signs, just minus them and take the sign of the largest value. Now that we have plus here, just minus this one. 12 minus 8 will give us what? 4. And the sign of the larger value is plus. Just leave it here as plus. You can rewind to get my statement again. And the last question we have here, the same rule. So you are multiplying the same sign, it is what to be plus. This is minus, this is minus. So by implication, it means we now have two. If this minus and this minus multiply to be plus, we now have 2 plus 11 to give us what? 13. Awesome. You can always go back, pause, and rewind this video to relate those rules that have been stated earlier with our calculation. They are very easy and straightforward. You can pause and rewind to get better clarification and understanding on this topic: addition and subtraction of directed numbers. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, My Simple Maths, and press the notification bell so that you can always get notification from us whenever we post a new video. Thank you.